بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series 200 Q&A concerning Aqeedah. Tonight, inshallah, we have segment number 60. This is segment number 60 and the question number 156. كم شعب الإيمان? How many branch of faith do we have? The branches of faith, إيمان. The answer is a statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 177. ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والنبيين وآتى المال على حبه ذو القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون. Righteousness is not turning your face to the right, to the east or the west, but righteousness is those who believe in Allah and the day of judgment, the angels and the books and the prophets, and give the property or the wealth, although he love it, to relatives, orphan, poor people, ibn al-sabil, welfarer, and the beggars, and to free the necks. And those who establish prayer and give the zakah, and those who keep their promise when they promise, those who are patient through difficulty and hardship, and during the time of the battle, indeed those are the truthful one, and those are the pious one. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us the righteousness is not turning to the east or the west. Doesn't matter the direction that Allah give you for your prayer, but the real righteousness, the iman, the taqwa, is that belief. And they start to say, "Man amana billah wal yawm al akhir," and he count all the articles of belief. And after this, he start to talk about establishing the prayer, giving the charity, and after this, they start to talk about those who keep their promise when they promise, those who are patient. So the verse had mixed between Islam, Iman, Ihsan, articles of beliefs, articles of Islam, and also about behavior. Among all these things comes to be the deen. Okay? All these things that have been mentioned and more is the deen of Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying al-iman bid'un wa sittuna wa fi riwayah bid'un wa sab'una shu'bah fa'alaha qawlu la ilaha illallah wa adnaha imatatu al-adha 'an at-tariq wal haya'u shu'batun min al-iman. Hadith in the collection of Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say faith, iman, 60 branch. In another narration, he say 70 some branches. The highest of it is the uttering of shahada, la ilaha illallah. The lowest of it is to remove the harmful things from the road. And to be bashful and shy is one of the branches of faith. So from this hadith, we can see how great Islam is, the deen of Allah. So great, so big. And like a big, huge tree, which is the highest of it, is the Tawheed. Testify to the oneness of Allah, that none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the highest of the whole deen, is the Tawheed of Allah. And the lowest of it is a person to be concerned for anything that may harm the Muslims that been thrown or been falling in their way. So he will go and bend down and pick it up and move it to the side or put it in the trash can. This also part of faith. So Iman is action and saying. Iman is action and believe. Iman is also the good deeds that you do it for the society to make them safe. Okay? And also includes the manner and the feeling. And he said, to be bashful is a branch of faith. Question 157. بما فسر العلماء هذه الشعب. How did the scholars explain the branches of faith? A lot of scholars had wrote and make books and make a lot of research about the branches of faith. But it's not that a must upon the Muslim to know everything by its name. Because if I ask somebody, count 70, three branches, tell me what it is. He may count 5, 10, 25, and after this, start to think. Okay? So the main things, the basic things to understand, to believe in all of it, and to do your best to try to act upon it, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do it, you do it. What Allah says, stay away from it, you stay away from it. If it's in the Quran or in the Sunnah. So the most important thing is not memorizing them by name, but that for you to act upon them whenever you see them in Quran or see them in the Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In addition to act, you have to believe. As example, if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us about Al-Mizan, which we mentioned in the Khutbah al-Jum'ah, the scale. So you have to believe in it. So there is some things that you have to do, some things that you have to stay away from it, and some things that you have to believe in it. So whatever requires for you to do in the Book of Allah or in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for you to do your best as much as you can to accomplish it in your life, and this is what we mean that you need to add to all the branches of faith. Although that the scholars count them and categorize them in different ways, but does not mean this what exactly the Prophet ﷺ meant in the hadith. Some people maybe count the bay'ah as branch of faith, while the other ones say jihad. Another imam will say amr bil ma'ruf wa nahi anil munkar. You see? So, but the Prophet ﷺ said in general that iman is 70 some branches. So some people, they may count 70. Some people maybe count 80, because it depends what they consider it as a branch or not. But the bottom line, what concerns us as Muslims, that when we see anything, Allah order it, what we're supposed to do, we do our best to follow it. Allah or His Messenger forbid it, we do our best to stay away from it. Allah or His Messenger inform us about Amarat al-Sa'ah, the signs of the Day of Judgment, for us to do our best to believe in it. Last question concerning tonight, inshallah. Question number 158. اذكر خلاصة ما عدوه. Mention a summary of what the scholar count to be branches of faith. Your deen. What is your deen is? Okay? So now, he said, Imam al-Hafiz ibn Hajar al-Asqalani in the book Fath al-Bari, which explained in Sahih al-Bukhari, he had mentioned what Imam ibn Hibban had said about the branches of faith. And he said, these branches of faith comes as a result of the action of the heart and the dawn of the tongue, or the sin of the tongue and the action of the body. So any act, Islamically, you act with your heart, like a belief, or do it with your tongue, like reciting Quran, or you do it with your body, like Salah and Hajj, this is part of the branches of faith. Anything, you do it with your tongue, to please Allah. Anything, you do it with your heart. How I do things with my heart? I believe in certain things. I try to implement or adopt a certain aqidah. I'm going to try to take out of my heart hatred, jealousy, envy. You see? So all these things. So now branches of faith is deals with the heart, the tongue, and what? The limbs of the body. فأعمال القلب فيها معتقدات المعتقدات والنيات. As for the action of the heart comes the belief and the intention, which he got 24 items under this. The work or the deed or the action of the heart under two main categories. One, intention. Okay? And the other one is the belief. This is the work of the heart. But under these two main categories, you can count 24 items. As example, believe in Allah, believing in His Asma, His names, His attributes, to believe that nothing similar to Allah, to believe in all His qualities, that He's all hearing or seeing, to believe that He is the creator and anything else other than Allah is His creation. This is very important. There is only one creator, only Allah, Almighty. Anything else you see or you touch, you know about it or you don't know about it, is the creation of Allah. هل من خالق غير الله? Is there any creator other than Allah? Of course not. So to believe in Allah as the creator and to believe that everything else is His creation. To believe in the angels, the books of Allah, the messenger of Allah, predestination. To believe in the day of judgment. And under this also to believe, or under this category, the su'al, the question in the grave. To believe in the resurrection. To believe in the judgment. To believe in the scale, in the sirat, the bridge over hellfire. To believe in Jannah. To believe in hellfire. And to love Allah. And to love for Allah. And to hate for Allah. And to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all this deed of the heart. And all this comes under the aqidah. So this part of the action. And the act of belief of the heart is more important than anything else. Because if the heart is not solid and correct, if the intention is not only for Allah, the deed is not accepted. So the most important thing, it comes number one, is the heart. Okay? And loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, honoring him, respecting him, and send the peace and the blessing upon him sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to follow his sunnah. Sincerity, and addition to this, leaving, showing off, hypocrisy, to have tawbah, fear of Allah, hope in Allah, to be grateful and appreciative to Allah, to keep your word, to be patient, to be pleased with the decree of Allah, to trust in Him and have mercy, to humble yourself to the others, and a part of it, respecting the older and be merciful in the youngest, and leaving alone arrogancy, and leaving alone jealousy, and not to be angry. 24 act of worship to do with your heart. Should we stop here? Or you want to hear the deed of the tongue? Enough? Yes? Maybe? Eh? Enough? Okay, we go according to the mu'adhin. Then, inshallah, we'll continue. Jazakum Allah khairan later on, tomorrow morning or tomorrow night. Or depend what Allah had decreed for us. Jazakum Allah khairan for being here. And for those who may have a question, comments, concern, you may present it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. And Allah knows best. May you have a good